noise pollution.
Any sound that disturbs you is noise pollution.
Well, I would say that, you know, noise that hits your ear upsets you.
For instance, the noise that cars made by honking, and then noise from bikes and trucks, and loud music at all sorts of odd hours.
If it happens enough that it disturbs your inner harmony, that would be noise pollution.
In the year 2000, the Government of India passed the rules on noise pollution. That's nearly two decades ago. The regulation provides a framework to protect ordinary citizens like you and me from high sound levels. A minimum decibel level for four categorized zones were created. In commercial areas, a limit of 65 decibel during day and 55 decibel during night are permitted. In residential areas, this limit is reduced to 55 decibel during daytime and 45 decibel during nighttime. While to allow industrial activity, the third category has a high limit of 75 decibel during day and 65 decibel during night. To test these regulations, we decided to record the decibel ALEC of these areas. We borrowed mostly from the Government of India's methodology on measuring noise pollution. The figure denotes the time-weighted average of the level of sound in decibels on a scale A, which is relatable to human hearing. That simply means the average sound you hear in these areas. The one type of area we haven't mentioned so far are silent areas. That's because it gets a little complicated here. Basically, silent areas have a limit set at 50 decibel during the day and 40 decibel during the night. But first, we need to understand what silent areas are. According to the rules, a silent zone is defined as an area comprising not less than 100 meters around hospitals, education institutions like schools, courts, religious places, or any other area which is declared as such by the competent authority. So here's where the problem lies. When categorizing a silent zone, which also has the lowest decibel limit, the region is based around a certain institute, and the whole point of the term silent area is probably aimed for the better functioning of that particular institute itself. But what if that institute is responsible for the violation of the decibel limit? One paradox of the silent zone phenomena are religious institutions. Communities based around such institutions can often be victim to the prayers produced via loudspeakers, easily crossing the decibel limit of silent zones. So in light of this, many such institutions are preparing to take measures in order to prevent such pollution, while others are still oblivious to the problem.
Kabhi-kabhi aisa hota hai ki shor-sharaba zyada hota hai to sar mein darad ho jata hai. सर में दर्द होता रात को नींद अच्छी नहीं आती जब रात को नींद अच्छी नहीं आती तो दूसरे दिन काम में मन भी नहीं लगता.
In a city like Delhi, filled with all kinds of problems, noise pollution, a problem not visible to the eye, can easily be ignored. Yet what cements this as a problem is the effect it leaves behind, ruining people's lives, one party, one firecracker, one horn at a time. According to the report of the committee appointed by the Bombay High Court for studying noise pollution in 1985, with more and more doctors engaging in research on the effects of noise, during the ensuing period, the concept of noise being a nuisance gradually changed to its being a health hazard. In a report by the World Health Organization, it was stated that noise-induced hearing loss is irreversible. Exposure to loud sounds for any length of time cause fatigue of the ear's sensory cells. The result is temporary hearing loss or tinnitus, a ringing sensation in the ear. Prolonged exposure can cause permanent damage, resulting in irreversible hearing loss.
Yam hai, market hai, yam ho aayi. Ab yam hai, wo horror market rakhte hain. Itne har aadmi bura lagta hai. Hame haath ki bimari hai. Kabhi kabhi aisa hoti hai na, main ghabra jata hu. Ye bimari ke bare mein haath wale ke liye horror marna bahut galat hai. Usme aur aadmi ghabra jata hai, mane bahut problem ho jati hai.
Damage caused by noise can range from the bursting of an eardrum, permanent hearing loss, cardiac and cardiovascular changes, stress and fatigue, lack of concentration, deterioration in motor and psychomotor functions, nausea, disturbance of sleep, headaches, insomnia, loss of appetite. The list goes on. The point is, noise is harmful.
Major causes of noise pollution.
In general, there's a lot of noise every day, even if there's no festival or event happening.
Traffic. Straight away, I think. Traffic is the biggest noise polluter.
Weddings, for instance, are a major source of noise pollution here.
People in India, they use loud volumes when they listen to music. They, loudspeakers in their religious functions, they use loudspeakers in their parties, they use loudspeakers in their marriages.
There are trucks carrying all sorts of things for the industrial area. They pass right through the residential area and there are horns and weird reverse alarms making all sorts of noises at all odd hours, like in the middle of the night. At around 11:30 the trucks just start coming in and then you know you can't sleep.
Some of the sources for noise pollution in the city are road traffic, air traffic, rail traffic, neighborhood and domestic noise, construction work, fireworks and festivals, among many more. Most of these are self-explanatory. The one word you see repeating itself is quite a major problem when it comes to noise pollution. Noise pollution due to rail traffic is generally confined to residents living along rail lines in urban areas. While they have become quieter over the last few years, railway noise remains a problem because of longer, more frequent and faster trains and the build-up of the urban environment. In the metropolitan area, it has been the cause of considerable community concern. Under Section 5 of the Aircrafts Act 1934, it is expected that aerodromes be constructed far away from residential areas of a city in order to protect residents from the noise created by frequent takeoff and landings. Road traffic is one of the biggest producers, if not the biggest producer, of noise pollution. In a developing country like India, where roads are in a bad condition, poorly maintained and have considerable number of vehicles of outdated technology, the road traffic noise assumes much more importance. Motor vehicle ownership has increased substantially over the last 30 years. With this, general levels of road traffic noise have also increased through the same period.
Loudspeakers used for festivals, parties, or even personal purposes can often be a major factor of noise pollution. The most alarming aspect about this is that it often occurs in residential areas for prolonged amounts of time and ends up directly affecting people where they're least expected, inside their homes. Festivals like Diwali, famously known for being a major factor of air pollution, is no exception to noise pollution. In fact, the Delhi Pollution Control Committee has a specific page on their website dedicated to the decibel recordings on Diwali night. The data on the page provides us with alarming figures, showing any kind of prolonged exposure would likely result in temporary, if not permanent, hearing loss. So that brings us to the final question. What can we do about this?
देखो ऐसे हम तो रोक नहीं सकते लेकिन हर इंसान अपने आप में एक कमिटमेंट करे कि हमारी वजह से किसी को तकलीफ हो रही है तो साइज हम कम कर सकते हैं.
Well, there are many ways one can avoid noise pollution, but the best way to eradicate it is to hit the problem at its source. According to this report by the Bombay Environmental Action Group, the National Physical Laboratory has found that Delhi, Bombay and Calcutta were the noisiest cities in the world. And that was back in 1998. Things have only gotten worse since then, and the fact is simple. Behind the production of such pollution sits one species. Humans. So So it's fair to say, if we can cause the problem, we can also stop it. In order to do that, an awareness needs to be awoken among the people. Spread the word. Honk less. Lower the volume. Keep your dog in check. And have a cracker-free Diwali. It helps the environment in more than one way. But most of all, it helps you.